रिपीट आफ्टर मी, योगेन चित्तस्य पदेन वाचा मलं शरीरस्य च वैद्यकेन योपाकरोतम् प्रवरं मुनीना पतंजलिं प्राञ्जलिं प्रणतोऽस्मि नित्यं हरिः वो श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः वो Take both hands behind your back, hold right wrist with left palm, inhale and go back, exhale, bend forward, pay your respects to Mother Earth, parents, teachers, God and Guru. Slowly inhale and come back. Good morning, welcome to Yoga Jyoti Yoga Classes. Today we are going to learn about Patanjali. Patanjali Maharshi and his Yoga Sutras. Okay. So, yes. Yes, somebody wanted to say something. Okay. So, we are practicing yoga, but what is yoga? What is the theory behind it? We have to learn. Okay. We have to understand what is yoga. So, in ancient India, there are 6 schools of philosophy. Okay, very ancient India. They are called as Shad Darshanas. Darshana means seeing, a vision, a philosophy. So there are 6 Darshanas. They are called Shad Darshanas. Yoga is one of them. And the sutras, yoga sutras, the formula, the codified formula for yoga are written by Patanjali Maharshi. He has codified yoga related to yoga. They are known as yoga sutras, Patanjali yoga sutras. There are many, many texts on yoga. But the one text, if we have to understand yoga, we have to study Patanjali Yoga Sutras. Today I will give introduction of that. If you are interested, you can learn later. I will conduct some other class on that. But here today, we are going to get some introduction about yoga. What is yoga? Okay. So, the Shad Darshanas, I think, are Nyaya, Vaisheshika, Sankhya, Yoga, Purva Mimamsa, and Uttara Mimamsa. These are the 6 Shad Darshanas. Yoga is one of them. Yoga teaches the discipline, the practices on how to attain liberation. Okay. Now, these are philosophies. Don't think that it is just a physical exercise. That's where I am conducting this class. Yoga is not physical exercise. Physical exercise is just one part of yoga. Okay. Yoga is much more than that. It's a whole system of philosophy. There is a whole system of philosophy involved in yoga. Okay. If you are interested, you have to study Patanjali Yoga Sutras. Okay. Of course, you have to understand it properly. Okay. So the Yoga Sutras are the foundation text of yoga written by Patanjali Maharshi. Patanjali Maharshi is the founder of yoga school. I mean, codified the formula. So every day we pray to Patanjali Maharshi before we start the class. What does that prayer mean? Somebody might have come up with that prayer. It is yogena chittasya. Chitta means mind. For the mind, yoga was given. Padena vacha. For the speech, grammar was given. Malam sharirasya cha vaidyakena. For the impurities in the body, medical text is given. So Patanjali Maharshi has written three great works. One is the Yoga Sutras for the mind, for yoga. And second one is the grammar, Sanskrit grammar, for the rectification of the speech. And third one is the medical text, Ayurvedic text. One of the Ayurvedic texts is written by Patanjali Maharshi for the purification of the body. So, since he has done such a great service to the mankind, we bow down to Patanjali Maharshi with respect every day before we start the yoga class. Okay. Now, the Yoga Sutra start with the first sutra, Adha Yoganu Shasanam. What that means is, Adha means after that. Yoganu Shasanam means yoga is prescribed. After that, yoga is prescribed. After what? After what is yoga is prescribed? After acquiring sufficient qualifications, student has acquired sufficient qualifications, he is taught yoga. Okay? So you can think of qualifications, a good moral and ethical conduct you can think of as a prerequisite for studying with yoga. In the modern world. Okay. Second sutra is Yoga Chitta Vritti Nirodaha. Yoga, repeat after me. Yoga Chitta Vritti Nirodaha. Yoga, definition of yoga is given in the second sutra of Yoga Sutras. Yoga Chitta Vritti Nirodaha. Chitta means the Antahkarana, the mind. What in English you call it as mind. In Sanskrit, there is no equivalent English word for Chitta. Chitta is called the Antahkarana in Vedanta. Chitta Vritti. The vritti means the modifications of the antahkarana. Chitta vritti nirodaha, containment of the modifications of the mind is called yoga. Okay? That means you have to have a control, containment of the modifications of the mind. What is chitta? Chitta is made up of four components. Manas, Buddhi, Chitta again, and Ahankara. These are the four components of Chitta. Chitta means the Antahkarana. The Antahkarana has four components. Manas, Buddhi, Chitta, and Ahankara. Manas means the instrument which creates thoughts, I, me, mine thoughts, I want this. Those thoughts are created by the manas. Buddhi is the one which decides whether to do or not. Buddhi is intellect. Chitta is memory. Whatever we do is stored in the memory. It is exactly like a computer process. Whatever is stored in the memory will be, records will be fetched, and buddhi will decide whether to do or not to do. Okay? And ahankara. Ahankara is ego. Ego is the sense of I am this body. Sense of I am this body. So this is the structure of antahkarana, structure of mind as envisaged by the ancient Indians. Manas, buddhi, chitta, ahankara. If you see your mind, all these four components will be there in your mind. Okay? So, what is the problem? The mind will keep on saying, I want this, I want this, I don't want this, I want this, I don't want this, I want this, I don't want this. That is the problem. Okay? And whatever is presented to us, to the sensory organs, mind will say, I want this or I don't want this. I like this or I don't like this. That is the problem. Okay? And whatever we have undergone in our previous lives and in this lifetime is stored in the memory system, in the chitta, in the memory system. And that will pop up an impression. It will pop up an impression. And that impression will color, will make us prejudiced with respect to the current experience. Okay? So, for example, there was a person who scolded me 20 years back and I was hurt at that time. Then, you fast forward to 2021, I see that person now, immediately my mind will be filled with hatred and fear because he scolded me 20 years back. I cannot take a impartial, non-judgmental judgment in the present moment. My judgments are always colored by the previous experiences. This is called conditioned mind. Imagine with one incident I have told you. That one incident colors my judgment. Now, in the entire lifespan, so many experiences I undergo and so many impressions I store in my mind. So, do I have a free will actually? Or am I working as per the recorded impressions? Obviously, the answer, if you look closely, is all our actions are as a robot. Recorded impressions will come up and I will exactly act as per my conditioning. It is like a rule. If this happens, I will react like this. So there is no way I am free. Is that clear to everyone? Is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the yoga is to make us free from the conditioning, from the chitta vritti. Chitta vrittis, how many types of chitta vrittis are there? Patanjali Maharshi is going to explain. So first you have to understand, chitta vrittis are there. Chitta vrittis means modifications of the mind. I mean the thoughts in the mind. So yoga chitta vritti nirodaha means, yoga means containing the modifications of the mind. So how you do that? Is various practices and understandings we have to do. So don't think that yoga is just about doing asanas. Yoga you have to do for containing the modifications of the mind. Okay? So that is the second sutra. So today I will just give you a brief introduction of yoga sutras. We are not going to study in detail. The third sutra is tada drashtu swarupe avasthanam. Tada drashtu swarupe avasthanam. Tada drashtu swarupe avasthanam. What this means is, when the chitta vrittis are contained, when yoga chitta vritti nirodha, chitta vrittis are contained, what is the phala, result of that is tada, after that, then drashtu swarupe avasthanam. You will be situated as the drashtu. Drashtu means the seer, the natural state. In your natural state, in your swarupa, you will be situated as your natural swarupa, stable. You will be very pure mind and stable. You will be situated in your natural state. That is the phala of containing the modifications of mind. Okay. So a person whose mind is clear and not having junk thoughts will be very peaceful and very balanced. That is the state we have to attain. Not some esoterical or mystical experiences he's talking about. He's talking about a natural state where you are calm, peaceful, and clear mind without any prejudices. Okay? And fourth verse, he says, vritti swarupyam itaratra. Otherwise, you will be caught up with the vritti. I mean, whatever thought comes, you will be caught up in that thought. You will become that object. For example, if you see, if you are thinking about something constantly, that will be what is going on in the mind. You are taken that shape and form. So remember, you have to remember, if you are holding any grudges or anger, jealousy or whatever it is, that thought will be uppermost in your mind. And that is the form, your form is that. Okay? Mentally, you take that form. If you are angry, you are angry. You take the form of anger. Okay? If you see a table, your mind will form an object of that table. And if you are thinking constantly about table, mentally you have become table. Physically, the body may be there, but mentally you have taken that form. Okay? So remember, what thoughts you feed is the form you will take. Okay? So better you think, have a good thoughts. Okay? Think about God and your swarupa will be God. Fifth sloka is vrittayaha panchatayaha klishta aklishta. It means, what are the vrittis? They are panchatayaha, five types. They are called klishta and aklishta. Klishta means difficult. Aklishta means easy, without difficulty. These vrittis create karma, with difficult karma influences and without difficult karma influences. Okay. Verse number 6, sutra number 6, pramana viparyaya vikalpa nidra smritayaha. So he is talking about the types of thoughts, the 5 vrittis. What are the vrittis? Classification of the vrittis: pramana, viparyaya, vikalpa, nidra, smritayaha. Pramana means the evidence, I mean proof, something which you can know through sensory organs. Viparyaya means illusory knowledge. Vikalpa means false knowledge. Nidra means knowledge of absence. Smriti means memory based. These are the 5 types of vrittis in your mind. Pramana means which you can see, sense, taste and touch. Viparyaya means illusory knowledge. Vikalpa means false knowledge. Nidra means knowledge of absence. Smriti means memory based. Sutra number 7. Pratyaksha anumana agamaha pramanani. He is explaining each one separately. What is pramana? Pramana means which is of pramana is also of 3 types. Pratyaksha, direct knowledge perceived through senses. You see, taste, touch, smell, hear. That is direct knowledge. It is called pratyaksha. Anumana means inference. For example, there is smoke on the mountain. So you can deduce there can be fire on the mountain. So that is called indirect knowledge, inference, inferential knowledge. Agama means scriptural knowledge or aptavakya. Scriptural knowledge means coming from the scriptures, authentic sources. Vedas, Vedanta, these are authentic scriptural knowledge. So only these 3, anuma, pramana is of 3 types, pratyaksha, anumana and agama. Pramana means the source of knowledge from which you can know anything. You can know in 3 types. Pratyaksha, direct knowledge using your sensory inputs. Or anumana, using logic, inference, you can deduce some knowledge. Or agama, scriptural knowledge. Is there any other 4th way? No. Okay. 8th sutra, viparyayo mithya jnanam atatropam pratishtam. Viparyaya, he is explaining. He has explained pramana. Now he is explaining viparyaya. Viparyaya means illusory knowledge. This is like we mistake an object for something else based on its shape. Okay? See, for example, if I make an aeroplane with a paper aeroplane I make, I see aeroplane, but I forget that it is paper, made up of paper. This is illusory knowledge. The knowledge of aeroplane is illusory knowledge because it is not aeroplane, it is paper. Okay, so this is illusory knowledge. The knowledge of aeroplane is illusory knowledge. Sutra number 9. Shabda jnana anupatti vastu sunyo vikalpaha. Vikalpa means false knowledge based on sound. That means you hear something and an object forms in your mind. That is a false knowledge. Sutra number 10, abhava pratyaya alambana vrittir nidra. Nidra means sleep. Okay? In the sleep, it is nothing but knowledge of absence. In deep sleep, you don't experience anything. This knowledge of absence is called nidra. एंड व्हाट इज स्मृति अनुभूत विषय संप्रमोषः स्मृतिः वी रिकॉर्ड आवर एक्सपीरियंसेस एंड प्ले इट बैक एज एंड व्हेन रिक्वायर्ड दिस स्मृति इज कॉल्ड स्मृति सो स्मृति इज व्हाट कंफ्यूजेस अस whatever has been recorded so many lifetimes will come up as soon as you see a new thing and we get conditioned and we act as per our conditioning so smriti we have to clear off so he is specifying sutra number 12 abhyasa vairagya tan nirodha so all these five vrittis can be contained, controlled or annihilated by abhyasa means practice and vairagya means detachment. So the way is also shown by Patanjali Maharshi in Sutra number 12. What is that? Abhyasa vairagya tan nirodaha. How do you contain the mind? All the five vrittis by abhyasa and vairagya. Okay, so I'll stop here. Any questions? Patanjali Yoga Sutras will go like this. There are four chapters in Patanjali Yoga Sutra, and we have to study it properly, understand it properly, so that you can say that you know what is yoga. And if you cannot understand what is yoga, yoga is not just physical exercise. Okay, we have been doing physical exercise so far, but it is more about making yourself peaceful and loving and compassionate. Okay, you have to bring more and more harmony into your body and mind. Okay, all right. Any questions or observations?
Sir?
Yes?
You said we have to erase the smriti, sir. Huh? But some memories are required.
Why?
Some may be good or some may be bad, I don't know. But we will be cherishing some memories, right?
We are not talking about that kind of memories. We are talking about impressions latent in the mind.
Okay.
Okay. See, it is not about memories in your cherished memories or anything. See, you have to understand what is memory, okay? Some memories are required for learning. Okay. Otherwise, all memories are false because they don't exist now. Okay. We are talking about something in a philosophical manner. We are not talking about a personalized person who wants to have some memories, enjoy the memories and all. For that person, yoga is not required because that person is a samsari anyway. Okay, yoga is philosophy is for a person who wants to understand what is truth and what is the solution to life's problems. It is not for living a normal life. Normal life, if you want to live, like with your life story and with your memories, yoga is not required. You can go to a gym and do gymming exercise. Yoga and philosophy, Vedanta, or other schooling systems, philosophical schooling systems is required for a person who is trying to find a solution to the problem of life. First thing is, people do not understand the problem of life itself. If you think carefully, there is a problem of life. In life, you have sometimes happiness, sometimes unhappiness. If you are okay with that, if you are okay to live like that, then yoga doesn't make sense. You don't require yoga for that. Okay? If you want to transcend unhappiness, if you look at your experiences closely, whatever is happy and unhappy, both leads to unhappiness only. There is no happiness in life. This is the great realization of Buddha. He said, life is dukkha. Dukkham, dukkham, sarvam dukkham. Life is dukkha, made up of suffering. Okay? So for a person who understands this, that person requires philosophy, not everyone. Okay? What we are doing is, we are learning everything just like any other subject. That is not correct. Yoga is not like any other subject. Vedanta is not like any other subject. You should be ready to understand what is truth. What is the reality of the world? You should be ready as a seeker, spiritual seeker. These are spiritual dimensions we are talking about. We are not talking about a person. I mean, personal experiences. I have some cherished memories and all. Once you transcend that, not as a person, when you can clearly see the life as it is, if you want to hold on to life, then philosophy is not required. Am I making clear? Did I make any sense, Kamala?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. Philosophy is not your everyday cup of tea.
Yeah.
Philosophy is to answer deeper questions of life. If you are ready to investigate life in detail, be a serious seeker, then philosophy is for you. So I gave a flavor of the philosophy here, yoga philosophy here. If you are interested, you can study. Otherwise, you treat this as an exercise, then it will not fetch you much. And then you will complain, I have these thoughts or that thoughts, I'm distracted, I have unhappiness. That will never go away.
Okay.
Okay, people always say, when I ask them to do meditation, they will say, I am not able to concentrate, I am not able to sit silently for some time. Why is that? Because of the thoughts. Vrittayaha, chitta vritti nirodaha. You are not able to do chitta vritti nirodaha. Why? Because of these five types of vrittis. Once you purify the chitta, then you are not troubled. And purification of chitta takes long time. Why? Because chitta is filled with so many junk thoughts of lifetimes after lifetimes. And cleaning up requires a lot of practice and struggle. So all of you, you come to the meditation class and say, we do for half an hour, and you expect to have a clearer mind. It will not happen. It's not so easy. We are all filled with so many latent impressions. And clearing up that latent impressions is very difficult. It requires a lot of practice. Peace is not easy. You won't get peace of mind so quickly, so easily. It's because we have trained our minds to go after the objects of the world. We have trained so much our mind for the objects of the mind, and we hold so many things dear to your heart. We are not ready to let go of it. But we want peace of mind. It will not happen. Peace of mind you cannot get if you hold things dearly to you. You have to let go. If you do not let go, peace of mind cannot happen. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Anybody has any question? Did you understand properly?
Yes, sir.
So this is an introduction to Yoga Sutras. Just I gave you a brief introduction. If you are interested, you can learn it. Make it as a serious study. Take your life. If you want peace of mind, you have to study properly. Apply the principles. These are not just like that. Don't treat it as a physical exercise. Okay? Not just physical exercise. Otherwise, you have gyms. You have so many physical exercise options are there. Okay, I'm just giving you an example. If you want to take life seriously and understand life, that life is suffering. Dukkham dukkham sarvam dukkham. Anityam anityam sarvam anityam. Okay, then you come to yoga or philosophy. All right. Okay, if anybody has any question, they can ask me.
What is anityam, sir?
Huh?
Dukkham dukkham sarvam dukkham. Anityam you told, what is that anityam?
Anityam means impermanent, impermanent, everything is impermanent. This is okay. In your everyday life, right?
Yes, yes. Yes,
everything is impermanent. There is nothing permanent here.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Anityam anityam sarvam anityam. Dukkham dukkham sarvam dukkham. Shunyam shunyam sarvam shunyam. This is what Buddha told. Okay. So if you want to learn something, learn it properly in its own terms, in its own terminologies. Philosophy, if you take up to philosophy, yes, it appears that whatever pleasures we have to let go, but it is not truly. The pleasures and the pains of our life are temporary, and holding on to that leads to unhappiness. We are always, if you honestly ask yourself, are you happy? Can you answer, I am happy? Anybody can answer? I am peaceful, I am happy?
No, sir.
No, sir. It's like in and out.
So the question is, how can I be happy and peaceful? That question has to be answered. A method has to be prescribed. A process has to be followed. So that, is there something called ananda, happiness, dukkha nivarana, removal of suffering? Otherwise, it will be roller coaster ride. Sometimes happy, sometimes unhappy. Are we satisfied with any given point of thing? No, we are not satisfied. Can I be fulfilled? If you can answer these questions honestly, you don't require yoga or Bhagavad Gita or anything. But if you want to be happy without suffering and fulfilled, you have to follow any of the philosophical systems. So that is the understanding of the life you should have. The life is impermanent and I am always unhappy. I am always unsatisfied, dissatisfied with life. Something or the other, I am running after something. What is going on? Why am I doing this? Why can't I be satisfied and contented all the time? Why can't I be happy? If you can answer these questions, if you can ask these questions, then yoga and philosophy is for you. Otherwise, yoga and philosophy is not for you. So it is up to you to decide whether you want to practice yoga in its proper form. You have to have a questioning mind. You have to have an investigative mind. Investigate into life. Why am I not happy? Why am I not peaceful? Why am I not satisfied? Why am I not contented? If you can ask these questions to yourself honestly, and you want to find answers, you have to look for any philosophical system, and yoga or philosophy or Vedanta, you have to take to recourse. Okay? Okay. Any other question? Otherwise, why what we do yoga every day, physical exercise, what it will fetch? Some physical improvement will be there, and that's about it. You are never fulfilled, you are never happy, you are never contented. Yoga is for happiness, contentedness, and fulfillment. Yoga chitta vritti nirodha. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
All right. So we'll close the session. Put namaskar mudra. Close your eyes. Repeat after me. Asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrutyorma amrutam gamaya om shanti 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 hari om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Hivo. Keep your hands in blessing posture. Bless the world. Bless the universe. Repeat after me. Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Fold your hands. Pray to God. Repeat after me. I am not the body. I am not the mind. I am not the intellect. I am pure consciousness. Shiva Swarupi. Shivoham. 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 Thank you. See you tomorrow.